Through your clit, you pissed on trip. I'ma have to brush you on your lips. And the whips better have a whole lot of chips, cause I ain't for no nigga giving tips. Run through your clit, you pissed on trip. I'ma have to brush you on your lips. And the whips better have a whole lot of chips, cause I ain't for no life for no run through your clit.
Hey everybody, welcome to my channel. So today's video is going to kind of be a two-in-one video, and I don't even want to get to explaining. I'm just going to start telling you guys exactly what I'm talking about. So basically, I did not slay this frontal like people expected me to, and like how I expected myself to slay it. And this frontal is from Forever Flawless Hair. I did do an initial review on this hair a couple weeks back. I'll link that in the description box below for those who missed it. But basically, I got four bundles of Peruvian loose wave in inches 20, 22, 24, 26 with an 18-inch lace frontal. And I decided to make it into a wig because, first of all, this is my first frontal I've ever worked with ever. And I just wanted to get a little bit of experience. I wanted to see what the hype was about, because frontals right now are very, very hot. And I just wanted to, you know, see if I can ride the wave, but I can't. So when I was making the wig, I found it extremely difficult for me to actually position the lace frontal right on the, you know, on the cap, to make sure that it was gonna fit my head. I use a standard size dome cap. I mean, not standard size dome cap. I use a standard size styrofoam head. So maybe that was the first step where I went wrong. And when I was placing it, I noticed that one side was like shifted over a little more than the other, but I didn't really pay much attention to it. But now that I've made the wig and I've actually got it on my head, I know where I messed up. So I'm just gonna show you guys. Boom.
Fill that pan with water.
Damn, my video.
You want to
I was recording. So yeah, guys. So when I was making the wig, I noticed that, again, like one side was shifted over a little more. I didn't think too much about it. But now that the wig is on my head, boom. So I did not slay this frontal at all whatsoever. Overall, the hairline, the way the frontal came was perfect for my hairline, so I didn't really have to do any customizing for it, so that was a plus. And then this side is like all the way back here, and like these are my edges right here, and it's just, it's a hot mess basically. And then I was trying to get the baby hair thing down, because I know in lace frontals that's basically how you have to cover the line of demarcation with the lace, but I just couldn't get it. And then the lace is just it's a hot mess basically. Like, I don't like lace frontals basically, so I'd rather stick to my closures. But I did want to tell you guys and be truthful and honest about me making a mistake, because a lot of people might be trying to make a lace frontal wig and it might not come out right. And after watching so many YouTube videos on how to do them and how theirs come out perfect and then yours doesn't, that happens to me all the time. So I mean, I want to make sure that everybody knows that I'm relatable and stuff like this does happen. But of course, it was my duty to review this hair and this frontal, so that's exactly what I'm gonna do. Despite the problems that's going on right now, I'm probably not gonna wear the wig out in public that much, because I did not put a what's that stuff called? I did not put an elastic band within the wig, because normally you'll put it on this side of the frontal and then this side of the frontal, but you see this frontal is like completely thrown off because I just completely jacked it up. But I am going to get close and show you guys what it's looking like up here. And the central part, it looks pretty good, you know, it's not that bad, but you know, the whole pulling it back and then, you know, wearing it up like that, you see that? That's not cute at all. So, with that being said, it's just gonna stay in the standard blase center part. I'm not gonna do all the closure tricks, putting it to a high bun, none of that stuff. No, I'm not doing it, because this, the way this is set up, it ain't meant for that. So, enough talking about my slip ups with the hair. Enough talking about my slip up with the frontal and how I actually made the wig. We're gonna talk more about the hair. Okay, so like I said, I did get 4 bundles of Peruvian loose wave in inches 20, 22, 24, 26. And I straightened the hair out. And what did I use in the hair? I don't remember if I even used anything in the hair. I didn't wash it, so this hair is not washed at all. So, I think, yeah, I just straightened it with my flat iron and I used the chase method. So, the hair is very silky. It does shed a little bit, actually quite a bit. Like, as I was running my fingers through the hair, there's a lot of strands on my pants. So, that's something that you guys might want to know. It does shed. So this is 26 inches and it's 4 bundles. But for me, I don't know, it just doesn't feel like it's, you know, as full as 4 bundles would be. So it's 26 inches and it goes all the way like down to my hip, a little past it. So I don't know, just as I'm doing this, I don't know, it just doesn't feel like it's full enough to be 4 bundles. But overall, I mean, it's cool hair. It's straightened out very nicely. It's silky without me washing it, so that is a plus. I'm not getting any tangling whatsoever. Like I said, I do get some shedding, so that's just some basic information you all should know about. When I got the hair, it did have the factory smell and stuff like that, but as I flat ironed it, the smell went away, so I wasn't really, you know, tripping too much on that at all. But and future references, if I do, you know, decide to go a little step further with this hair, with this wig in general, despite, you know, what's going on with this frontal, I might cut some of the ends because it is kind of thin at the bottom. So I might cut some of the ends just to get the hair a little bit more fullness and might add some curls. So that might be the next video that will be coming about this hair, which will be styling. But again, this is Forever Flawless Hair and I will leave their information in the description box below, all their social media, the exact hair I got, the lengths, all of that stuff. So basically, again, another main reason why I wanted to make this video and get it to you guys is to let you all know that mistakes happen, especially when it comes to these wigs. I'm not a perfect wig maker. And I mean, as far as trying things out and, you know, trying out new things, I've learned to accept the fact that everything is not gonna come out perfect the first time around. This is a main example. Of course, I'm gonna make it look presentable enough for me to come on camera and make a video. I'm not gonna make a fool out of myself. When you wanna get down to the nitty gritty, this ain't that. So, with that being said, I'm just gonna be wearing the frontal exactly like this. I'm not gonna be switching apart, doing all the part in the braid and none of that. Like I said, it's gonna stay strictly like this, like a basic ass wig. Maybe in the future, you know, I might step up my game when it comes to these frontals and I might be able to come back on here and show you guys a slayed frontal wig. But as far as that goes, I made a mistake and I just want to let you all know that it happens, especially for me. So yeah, guys, make sure you check out the description box for more specs on this hair if you're interested. Like I said, this is 20, 22, 24, 26 with an 18-inch frontal. 4 bundles. I use all 4 bundles. And yes, guys, so that is pretty much it. Thank you guys so much for watching. Leave comments, give this video a thumbs up, and I will see you guys in my next video. Bye.